Hello and welcome to NewsClick. I'm Paranjoy Guha Thakurtha, and we are going to discuss the issue of defamation suits against media organizations that have been instituted by the Anil Ambani Group. With me here in the studio, I'm happy to have Apar Gupta. He's an advocate. He's been working on free speech issues for some years now. He was part of the constitutional challenge to criminal defamation in the Supreme Court, helped Member of Parliament Tathagat Satpathy draft the private members bill seeking to decriminalize defamation. Apar, these two defamation suits that have been instituted by the Reliance Dhirubhai Ambani group, headed by Mr. Anil Ambani, yes, against NDTV, yes, and against the Citizen, yes, in one case 10,000 crore, in another case 7,000 crore, for writing, reporting, analyzing the Rafael deal, the Rafael scandal. Would you describe this as a classic slap or a strategic litigation against public participation aimed at intimidating and harassing these media organizations?
I think it's much more than a slap, it's a punch. So what are slap suits? It's necessary for people to first understand it, Paranjoy. Now, when defamation cases or ye jo manhani ke jo case hote hain, they come in two varieties. Ek civil hote hain, jisme log paise mangte hain, paise ka dawa karte hain court jaake. Aur dusra hota hai jab wo criminal case file karte hain, jise bolte hain complaint case, usme wo police ke paas nahi jaate, par wo criminal court jaate hain. दोनों जो केस
मगर जेल जा सकते हैं
पर जेल जा सकते हैं दो साल के लिए जेल जा सकते हैं पर बेलेबल ऑफेंस होता है तो मतलब पहली पेशी पे जब डिफेंडेंट को समन आता है तो वो बेल ले लेता है पर फिर उसे वकील रखना पड़ता है कोर्ट के अंदर और ये सुनवाइयां काफी सालों तक चलती हैं तो काफी इससे लोगों पे असर पड़ता है पर आज हम सिर्फ सिविल केस के बारे में बात करेंगे क्योंकि जैसे आप कह रहे हैं स्लैप सूट जो हैं जब फाइल किए जाते हैं तो सिविल भी किए जा सकते हैं क्रिमिनल भी किए जा सकते हैं पर अनिल अंबानी जी ने जो किया है वो सिविल मानहानि के दावे हैं
मगर ये जो अमाउंट्स है एनडीटीवी के खिलाफ 10,000 करोड़ सिटीजन के खिलाफ 7,000 करोड़ एंड बोथ दीज केसेस हैव बीन लॉज्ड इन अहमदाबाद एट द हाई कोर्ट ऑफ गुजरात Now, don't you think there should be some sort of a restriction? Some of the high courts say that if you seek damages worth a certain amount of money, then you have to put a certain amount, a proportion of that amount as court fees. Now, it seems Ahmedabad doesn't have such a rule and you have to deposit a flat fee, correct me if I'm wrong, of 25,000 rupees. Is this the reason why Ahmedabad has been selected?
No, there may be several reasons. सबसे पहली चीज़ इसमें यही होती है कि कैसे जो defendant है उस पर जो प्रोसेस ही है जो मानहानि के मुकदमे का प्रोसेस है क्योंकि हम सब जानते हैं कि भारतीय कोर्ट कर या परसों तो नतीजा देंगे नहीं उसमें सालों लगेंगे तो द प्रोसेस बिकम्स द पनिशमेंट जिसमें आप अगर आरोपी ही हैं कॉन्विक्ट नहीं है अभी तक मतलब कोर्ट ने नहीं बोला है कि ये आरोप साबित हो गए पर जब तक सालों तक चलेगा कोई ना कोई एनडीटीवी का जो रिपोर्टर होएगा एडिटर होएगा जिसे भी डिफेंडेंट बनाया होएगा एनडीटीवी के सिवाय उनको ये केस फॉलो अप करना पड़ेगा
मगर वहाँ पे जाना पड़ेगा
वहाँ पे जाकर वकीलों से बात करनी पड़ेगी फॉर्मल रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं है सिविल केस में कि पर्सनल अटेंडेंस होए
मगर क्रिमिनल केस
पर क्रिमिनल केस में सिविल केस में सिर्फ उन्हें प्लीडिंग वेरीफाई करनी है पर इन सबसे एक बार पीछे हटते हैं और एक बार ये सीधे अमाउंट्स पे जाते हैं बिकॉज मीडिया में सबसे ज़्यादा बात जो हुई है और चर्चा जो हुई है वो हुई है कि ये हजारों करोड़ में जो दावे डाले हैं उनसे उससे फर्क क्या पड़ता है और उससे अगर अनिल अंबानी का जितना जितना घाटा हुआ उतना ही उसे पैसा मिलेगा अल्टीमेटली अगर घाटा नहीं हुआ है तो कोर्ट इनको बेबुनियाद बोल देगा और इन्हें छोड़ देगा तो फर्क क्या पड़ रहा है देखो फर्क ये पड़ रहा है कि एनडीटीवी एक न्यूज संस्था है It is a news organization, and there is a very good precedent in the United States, which is called New York Times versus Sullivan. It was a constitutional court case. इसके अंदर United States के सर्वोच्च न्यायालय ने ये बोला था कि अगर defamation cause भी हो जाती है किसी public figure को और public interest में आपकी speech है, तो damages cannot be excessive. मतलब अगर आपने मानहानि करी भी है, तो ये नहीं कि आपका पूरा धंधा बंद कर देंगे. क्यों? क्योंकि बहुत बारी जो पत्रकार लिखते हैं वो गलत होता है, क्योंकि जो लोग, जो पब्लिक पर्सनालिटीज होते हैं, जो पब्लिक ऑफिशियल्स होते हैं, वो इन्फॉर्मेशन ही नहीं देते. और हम तो जानते हैं आरटीआई का क्या हाल है इंडिया में. तो अगर आप एक की जगह 1.5 लिख देते हैं तो ये आपकी गलती है, ये मानहानि भी हो सकती है, पर आपका पूरा कारोबार और आपका पूरा काम नहीं बनता.
ओके, सो द पॉइंट यू आर सेइंग कि एज इन द सलिवन केस, सलिवन वर्सेस न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स केस, जो आपने दावा कर रहे हैं मानहानि का मामला में, ये ज्यादा होना नहीं चाहिए. साथ साथ एक चीज और आप बताइए, जो अंग्रेजी में कहते हैं चिलिंग इफेक्ट. बिकॉज इवन व्हेन द प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंसेज वर हेल्ड बाय यशवंत सिन्हा, अरुण शौरी, प्रशांत भूषण, देयर वर नोटिसेस सेंट टू मेनी मीडिया ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस कि ये मत कवर करो, ये मत कवर करो. So the whole idea was to dissuade and tell people, look, these cases can last for years, the long arm of the law can be really long, the wheels of justice can grind very, very slowly, excruciatingly slowly, don't mess around with us. Is that also the intention, to have this kind of a chilling effect?
Certainly, and we've seen it in the most visible instance in the IIPM case. IIPM as a company does not offer educational courses any longer. Only a few months back, its litigations against Google and Caravan were still proceeding.
Though the organization itself was virtually wound down, and
these cases originated in Silchar, Assam. They were for exaggerated amount of damages. So it follows the same template. You take an interim injunction, you bring a person within the purview of law, and you impact them severely. There are other side effects and second order negative effects as well. All media organizations today are facing challenges with respect to their funding and also generating revenue. And we need to recognize that media organizations today exist on the amount of money. Reporters who work there, resources which they have, ground reports which they make require money. Now, a lot of this kind of funding by itself comes through guarantees, loans, and Paranjoy, you've written about it, how stressed this sector is by itself. Now, what happens when a 10,000 crore claim is filed against any media company, and these are companies?
It becomes difficult for them to raise funds.
Yes, because it shows as a pending litigation, and that too by such a large
amount of money.
Group.
That's right.
By the Ambani group.
So, आपका ये कहना है कि इस तरह से धमकी दे रहे हैं, also to financially make
cripple, cripple. So it does have a chilling effect. The other media organizations then adopt a much more cautious approach. And you know this better than me. How do editorial room meetings work? Let us do this story is pitched by a reporter. The editor says it's a good story. Then there's some small investigation to get to know what's the basis of the story. But then slowly on, it's discovered that, oh, there are also pending litigations relating to this story. So there is a chance that it may become litigious. Okay. The second thing is, even if the story goes ahead, you still send it to a lawyer to review.
Okay. So
and the lawyer is conservative. The lawyer is not a journalist. The lawyer's interest is in preventing the very existence of the litigation. It sucks out the public interest from your story itself and a lot of the details.
And dissuades them from doing further investigations and reportage.
Exactly. Because a reporter who investigates one story and one company is usually a reporter who gains inside knowledge and access to sources and then follows it up in a series of reports. So the first defamation case on the first report by itself by a lot of companies and corporates actually squelches the actual meat of the report, which is to follow the entree.
So what advice would you give to NDTV, to Citizen? Unko kya karna chahiye? Aap vakil ho ke kya salah denge?
See, as a lawyer, I can only advise that prepare a proper chain of documentation and engage the right lawyers.
Okay. Now, all I'm saying now, let's move to the big issue, jo bada mudda hai. Ki you have worked on the constitutional challenge to criminal defamation. The Supreme Court bench under the former Chief Justice of India, Mr. Deepak Mishra, ruled. He sort of, the way I understand that lengthy judgment, is that it sort of put on more or less on a par or almost on balance an individual's right to her or his reputation and the right to free speech. what is the argument that it is about time India decriminalized defamation? What is the argument? Because people can argue that why should it not remain, why can you not have criminal defamation? So what if it was a colonial era law?
So I think there are several things which are wrong with the reasoning of the court, but you have gathered the gist of it correctly. Deepak Mishra places, the Supreme Court places the right to reputation as well as the right to freedom of speech and expression on equal plane, but they're not equal because our constitutional right to free expression, which is under Article 19(1)(a), has a specific exemption, which is a reasonable restriction and is expressly mentioned as defamation. These words are there. So your primary rule is the right, which is your natural right, which is free expression, and there's a restriction to it. So the restriction cannot be put on an equal plane by elevating it and linking it to reputation, because it's already there, it's much more specific. Now, beyond the legality, I think today the political discussion which needs to proceed is in the manner of criminal law reform. You need to first make sure that the freedom of speech and expression is protected, but at the same time make sure that people are not harmed by injurious speech and the process of defamation works. It works in a manner...
You are saying that every citizen's right, which is the right of the person, which is the right of the person, and this is the 19(2)
article, it has to be given proper
right. Reasonable restriction, which is the right of the person.
Parliament has to today step in practically, Paranjoy. It has to legislate on legislation in a way which protects free expression, but at the same time gives a effective remedy, not a punitive remedy, but an effective remedy to a person who has been defamed. It should provide for various provisions. For instance, that I need to mandatorily send a notice to the person who has defamed.
So, you are saying that this is necessary to change the law.
Yes.
Or it's not enough to just say, move a sort of a review petition or a curative petition against what the Supreme Court bench ruled.
उसकी संभावना ज़्यादा मुझे नहीं दिखती क्योंकि आज की डेट पे जो ज़्यादातर लोगों जिनके पास पावर है जिनके पास स्टेटस है जो पदों पे बैठे हैं वो ही इस्तेमाल करते हैं डेफेमेशन लॉ का ज़्यादातर ये सही बात है कि मतलब आजकल क्योंकि सोशल मीडिया इतना फैल गया है मानहानि के मुकदमे ज़्यादातर लोग शहरों में भी फाइल करने लगे हैं जो ऐसे पदों पे नहीं बैठे हैं पर ज़्यादातर जो डेफमेशन है it is done and alleged by people to be done against them when they are public officials or their public personality. So I think they have immense power and they by themselves will not, the prevailing public sentiment will not be in favor of a constitutional challenge per se, given that the judgment just came in 2015. So the first thing is we need to look at defamation and why is defamation there? Defamation is to redress your injury in which your name has been sullied, right? And that can not be done by 10,000 crores. That has to be done by an apology, a correction, which is proportionate to the actual injury caused to you. The remedy needs to be effective. It has to give a fair chance to both parties to contest the truth and establish it. Defamation is essentially about establishing the truth in the court of law and not using and gaming the processes which have developed due to delays in our court system to make sure that I take an interim injunction, prevent you from publication of the article today and then sit on it for a decade. And this is the problem. We need to cure it by law. And when we do it, I think criminal defamation will go by itself. And these kind of suits in Ahmedabad for 10,000 crores will stop.
Thank you so much, Apar, for giving us your time and explaining.
Thank
you, Dhanyavad. Thank you for being with us. You just heard Advocate Apar Gupta explaining what needs to be done, in what manner Parliament needs to amend the existing laws pertaining to manhani. Defamation. Thank you for being with us. Keep watching NewsClick.